Ahead of an important series against Australia Down Under, Indian skipper Virat Kohli spoke on the team's preparation and what the team learned from the mistakes of England's eras. While Kohli was happy with the way his bowlers performed, he urged his batsmen to step up during this eras.
I feel that we definitely have made decent progress, but there's still a lot of room for improvement. And that's something we realize as a team also. The thing is that we understand within the group what we need to work on. So it's up to the individuals to take ownership of that, take responsibility, and the things that are explained, that are laid out as expectations from a team culture point of view or team goal point of view, that can only be achieved when individuals go and work on those things. So there were a lot of things that we sat down and figured out after England what went wrong. To be honest, we all felt that there was not much that went wrong, but whatever was not right was very extreme also. So we played good cricket, but the mistakes were also very extreme. That's why we lost that many number of games rather than winning those moments and winning the games. So we need to strike a decent balance of when the situation is against us, how to control it better, and how to find a way out of it rather than wanting to get out of it immediately. So I think those are little things that we need to work on, and myself on an individual level, I would like to do those things more, and we expect that from the whole team as well, that individuals take more responsibility, show more character in those situations and assess it and then find a solution rather than thinking that the solution will appear from somewhere. So I think those are things that we really are keen on showing now in our next venture, and especially in Test cricket, because as Ravi mentioned, in T20s and ODIs we played really good cricket. So I think it's Test cricket where we really need to tighten things up and keep moving forward and correcting those mistakes. See, again, if we look at the England tour, apart from the game in Lords, there was no other game where we got bowled out as such, dominated totally, where we got bundled out in one session totally. And I think we batted well in patches. But what happens is when you have a situation or a phase where you don't bat so well as a team and you lose the game, that can really dent you mentally. So the challenge is how to get up from that, because when we play away from home, those things are going to happen. Any side that is playing in their conditions is not going to come and let you dominate the game. So we have to understand firstly how to control that situation better, so that it's not so radical that we can't get our heads ahead from that. And secondly, if that happens in any case, we have to understand how to refresh and focus on the next match as a new game, rather than letting it build on or pile on. And that has happened to me in the past. That can be a massive factor where people start thinking about the last innings or the innings before that, or thinking of that as three innings in a tour, rather than just focusing on a new innings, which is for the team, a new session, a new hour, a new over, a new ball. You have to keep breaking it down. So that's something again we've discussed with the whole batting group, how to focus on staying in the present, and that is something that personally has worked for me, to be able to stay in that particular minute and not think of anything else, where I'm playing, what are the expectations, are people going to write or not write, or what are they going to say. None of that matters, because when you're facing the ball, it's just that ball coming towards you. You don't even see the bowler after the ball's left from the hand. So these are things we've spoken about. If we implement that, the talent is there. We all have no doubts on it. Everyone will agree. So there's little things that we need to solidify and make sure that, when the situation's against us, we know how to block it, or we know how to get over that situation quicker.
One final
one. Yes, I definitely believe so. From the last time we went there, the fitness levels are definitely way up, which I think is the most important factor in Australia, because the pitches can get really boring at times and the ball doesn't move so much, the kookaburra. So it's about patience and it's about maintaining that pace which you start your day with, and maintaining that same pace throughout the day. That's why a team like South Africa has done well, where Amorkel, Callis back in the day, Steyn, now Rabada, these guys have relentlessly bowled in the right areas to get those wickets for their team. So we definitely believe that our guys are good enough to do similar kind of job. But again, I don't want to focus too much on that again, because yes, we are all feeling good about the fact that we have a great bowling attack now, but the batsmen need to step up as well, which we have spoken as a team again after England, and everyone's really keen to, you know, correct those things and put in a complete performance. So we put in a complete performance for a game. Sir, I can't say that. My idol is always one of the idols. Do you like to apologize
for that comment?
I've made my clarification on Twitter.
That's clear, yeah.